Hey guys, good morning. Welcome to today's video. Thanks for tuning in again. This is stage three of Tour Watopia. It's called the Queen stage. And I've heard that term used before in real life races. I'm assuming it has something to do with climbing. So if it is, it's a good stage to name it, because I will be doing the Alpe du Zwift climb today, which, if you're unfamiliar with, Alpe du Zwift is named after Alpe d'Huez, and it's one of these monumental climbs that they do in the Tour de France. They don't do it every year, but anyway, that is what it's named after. And it actually looks similar to if I were to ride the real Alpe du Zwift. So this is another women's only stage that I'm doing. So pure climbing, and I am not a pure climber, so it will be interesting to see how I place or where I place among other women. I am not hopeful I'll be placed closely to top 10 like I have in the previous two stages, but hoping that I do okay on it. The strategy for this is keep it at tempo for one or two thirds of the way up, and then see how I feel from there, and then bump it up the threshold or so. As you guys saw from my stage one results, I burned too many matches in the beginning of the ride. So that is not something I want to happen today, as I'd like to place highly on it, but I also don't want to go too hard where I blow up. So that's the strategy, is tempo about a third or the two thirds of the way in, and then reassess where I'm at, and then go from there. The bike that I'm riding is a Specialized Aethos. Thankfully, Jason did his research. This is supposedly the best bike for climbing. I don't have the Tron bike, as I mistakenly did not sign up for the Everesting challenge. So I would have gotten it by now, but did not. The wheels are the wheels by Roval, and also pretty lightweight, good climbing wheels. I don't have the Milesteins that Jason has, but that's supposed to be an even better wheel set to do climbs in.
I think it's actually the same as the Roval's.
Oh.
They're both the same speed.
Milesteins are like, I think they're like $5,000 to $10,000. Really expensive, super lightweight. In real life. So that's the gear that I'm using for this. I'm starting to kind of research what bikes to use on these different courses. So you're probably wondering what I'm doing. I'm just warming up for now. The actual event doesn't start until in 13 minutes. So just warming up my legs, getting them going before I hop onto the event. I also have the Milan Sanremo race going, so we're watching that as well. So it's gonna be, right now they're at 130 miles, so less than 130, 129.8 miles left into the race. So it's gonna be a while before they finish this one. I don't think it's gonna take me that long to do Alpe du Zwift. I'm factoring around, depending on my pace, 115, an hour, 15 minutes. So we'll see how I do. Whoops. My avatar is turning around. Why is it turning around? That's odd. Yeah, that's been kind of happening lately. Luckily, this is just a warm-up, but I didn't actually want my avatar to turn around. I think it's responding to my phone. Every time I move my phone or I pick it up, sometimes it makes my avatar turn around. So let's see if we can make a U-turn. There we go. Going back up. So let me just see if I can give you guys the stats. The route that we're riding this on is the Road to Sky. So I think it's 10.9 miles with 3,431 feet of climbing. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to ride with the front group in the beginning, and then from there I'm just gonna let them go and I'll do my own pace. Because I'm sure that there are pro women who are riding this, and I'm nowhere near that category. All right, so we got 9 minutes and 40 seconds left before the event starts. If you guys would like to, you can fast forward to the beginning of the race, and I'll put it in somewhere in the bottom of the video what the time stamp is, so you can fast forward to that. I'll just be spinning my legs here, and if you hear somebody talking, Jason is actually riding next to me, so he's also doing the stage 3 Road to Sky route. He's gonna do the open category, whereas I'm doing the women's category. So I'll try to get his video up as well. He did stage 2, recorded that, but we didn't get his, We'll try to get his image or his video along with the ride that he did with the race. And he did not record for stage one, so you won't see that. All right, well, I might not be talking a whole lot throughout this, may or may not. Full concentration, I guess, even though Milan Sanremo is playing right now. Okay, I'll see you guys at the start line. It looks like they don't have any commentaries yet. On this, on the beginning part of the race. Okay, we got a minute left before the start, and there are 28 women now who've joined in and counting. Let's see if others have a similar set up to mine. Oh, somebody is riding a mountain bike. Ooh, on the left there. A couple of Tron bikes.
Past me down this hill, but that's okay. Not concerned with it. Sticking to the plan. Saving myself for the climb.
Waiting for these ladies to catch me. So we'll see how many of us in this front group will stick together all throughout the climb. This is a good pace now. Oops. Not that I am. Get caught by a larger group here. All good. Oh, someone's going off. Oh, crash at Milan San Remo. Right. Movie star team. BSM. And three riders from... What team is that one? CSF.
These lower slopes of the climb are pretty steep, so going a little bit above my target just on this part. And then I'm going to back it off.
You guys here talking. I also have the, you probably already know this, but I have the Milan San Remo race playing in the background, so you'll hear the commentaries. All right, start of the climb is approaching. Just gonna keep it steady here at tempo. You know, let these ladies go. Twenty-one switchbacks. I'm gonna try to keep it seated and getting up once in a while just to relieve the pressure.
I think that the process of the process is kind of not comfortable.
This is the steep part where these hairpin turns are.
I
Come on. What happened to the commentaries? say low battery. I thought it's charging. Excellent. Well, battery's gonna run out. I thought I had it attached to the external battery. Wonderful. Sorry guys, you might not get footage at the end here. Thank you. Sorry guys, battery just died. Your camera died too. Bam. Ah.
Yes.
You heard it?
Yeah.
Good job, honey.
No.
Ah.
Oh.
Maybe do me a favor when you get a chance. Unplug and plug the camera back into the battery.
Change the battery?
No, unplug it and plug it back in. Just plug the bottom part.
Right here.
Unplug it, yeah. Plug it back in. All right, turn on the camera, record it. That's good. Record it.
Oh, it's recording.
Can you press the screen? Press the screen, just tap it. Just tap the screen.
Okay.
Okay, thanks. Thank you.
Camera died at some point during that climb, so I don't have footage at the end of it. I do have the footage from the way. I just don't have footage of myself suffering at the end. Oh boy. Well, I achieved my goal, which was to PR in Alpe du Zwift climb.
Are you still recording?
Yeah.
No, the screen?
Yeah. My goal is to PR the Alpe du Zwift climb and to finish it in less than an hour. And when I finished it, I got a notification on the screen that said I finished it in less than an hour. It didn't tell me my specific time though, so I'm going to have to check that out later on Strava or something. I mean, my time for the race was an hour and almost 8 minutes, but that includes the lead-in. Just gotta get my bearings here and then. Get back on the bike and start cooling down. As soon as I think I'm able to eat, I'll eat something, some sugars, but I just feel like I can't put anything in my stomach right now. My heart rate, you might have noticed, my heart rate didn't get tremendously high, aside from the fact that my heart rate runs on the low side. I was doing fairly low cadence there. I had my trainer difficulty on max, so I was feeling all the 10% grades and so forth. And if I'm on a 10% grade, even in my 36th, 34th year, if I'm riding around threshold, I'm only doing 80 RPMs, something like that. I would guess my average cadence for this climb was probably something like 75 to 80, which is slower than my preferred cadence, but, you know, I figure I'll just experience the grind, because if I was on a real world climb that had these grades, I'd be grinding. So it's good good muscular endurance training too, I think. And now, the fun part, descending the Alp. My avatar is a much better descender than I am. So, fortunately, he'll do all the handling, and I'll just chill.
Oh God, I feel like I'm on my limit.
Yeah, it's amazing how quickly you go from feeling good to feeling done. About the halfway point, I was still feeling pretty good. And then, when there were about, I don't know, five switchbacks left or something, I was finding it really hard to maintain my power. I had to just go into a bigger gear and just try to muscle it, because I was just, almost like my brain was getting too lazy to turn the legs over. My brain is like, I don't want to do this anymore. But I'm glad I didn't stop, because the end result was what I wanted. And it was worth it. Worth the effort. I suppose you guys don't watch me noodle here. Let me see if I can figure out how to let me see if there's a way to bring up my power curve. I think I might have to end the ride to do that. Well, minute power was 248, and I did pretty much the same power on all of those switchbacks. So I'm guessing my power for the climb is probably like 245 or something like that, which for me is like upper sweet spot. It's like 95% of FTP. So pretty happy with that. I guess I'll end it there. Hope that some of you out there are having fun with this these Zwift events. Even if you're not racing, you still need to race it. You can still have fun with it. Well, thanks for those of you who are excited to watch this. Appreciate your support. And thanks for liking and subscribing to the channel. And hope you can get out there and enjoy some rides. See you later.
Oh God.
Good job, honey.
Oh, that was awful. That was absolutely awful. Oh. I need my puke bucket. Oh god. That was rough. Oh my goodness. That was awful, guys. Well, thankfully Jason was able to fix the camera. I had the camera on attached to an external battery, and somehow it's still not, it wasn't charging it, so it died on me. So here we go. Now I got a feather. Perfect. I was able to snag a power up, but it was a draft power up. I think I made it top 10. I wasn't even paying attention. I think I did.
Yeah, I think you were 10.
So, better than I expected. I think it took me an hour and 23 minutes to do this event. I don't know my time going up Alpe du Zwift, but hey, Katie Kookaburra is in here. Look, in the chat.
I'm trying to find her.
She's way ahead.
Oh,
watch,
okay.
There's the chat.
Okay. Awesome.
Well, she didn't do the women's only.
Sure. Her time was faster than mine, I'm sure.
Whew. Well, now I will be descending. Just gotta spin my legs. Oh, heart rate's down now. Ugh. So my strategy for doing tempo sort of worked. Except my power started dropping off towards the last few switchbacks. So it didn't really work out as I had planned, but still a good ride. So in 25 minutes, I will be joining a 100K group ride. It's called ZHR ODAX. So I think I'm going to end it here, guys. Since I'm still gonna need to stretch my legs out, use the bathroom before I start the other ride. Oh, and I have to have a snack before I do the 100K ride, if I even get to finish it. So yeah, hope you guys like this video. As always, I appreciate the recent subscribers as well as the OG subscribers. Until next time, guys, don't forget to enjoy your rides. Bye-bye.